Damage to the rear wing. You have damage to your rear wing. Suggest we box to repair it. The underbody's taken some damage. I suggest we box so we can check it out. The rear wing is stuck open. We need you to pit in so we can try to repair it. Pit in for repairs. Okay, we can take you this lap. The rear wing is stuck open. We need you to pit in so we can try to repair it. Pit in for repairs. Norris, but...
To remind ourselves of our top three.
Moore, Verstappen and Carlos Sainz.
With qualifying wrapped up, we now have our grid lineup for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then for what will no doubt be a... So here we are then, welcoming you today to one of the jewels of the Arab world, Jeddah. One of the biggest cities in Saudi Arabia, second only to Riyadh, gateway to Mecca, and one of the biggest ports in the region. And now, host to the Saudi Arabia Grand Prix. An interesting circuit this one, the newest on the Formula One calendar, and like most street circuits, it's sure to present the drivers with an interesting technical challenge. Some challenging turns for the drivers to negotiate as well, and at the same time they're going to have to manage their tyres very carefully in this heat. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Moore lines up on pole position, and talented Spaniard Carlos Sainz completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Norris, Bottas, Charles Leclerc and Ricciardo, Matsushita, Perez, Russell and Antonio Giovinazzi, Verstappen, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, Ocon, Lance Stroll and Vettel, Gasly, they've taken a grid penalty, Joe, Mick Schumacher and Nikita Mazepin, Tsunoda, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, and Nicholas Latifi. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
is available on the MFD. Copy, approaching the safety car. You're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. Okay, the safety car is coming in this lap. We'll be pacing the field in sector 3. Make sure to respect the delta until the safety car is in the pit lane. Thank you. fantastic drive. Just fantastic. You deserve that race win.
And that brings the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix to a close then, as we reflect on the team's impressive performance today.
Ant, talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, they played the safety car to absolute perfection. There are so many factors to worry about once the race is neutralised. I mean, do you pit for fresh rubber? Do you have the space behind you? How much fuel can you save? If you answer all of those questions correctly, you'll have a good chance. And that's exactly what happened today.
Here come our winners now. A thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. Let's have a look then at the driver's standings. This result narrows the gap between our championship leader and the rest of the standings. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I'll probably go for Pierre Gasly. The team did a good job with the strategy to put him in amongst the pack, but it's the driver's job to capitalise on those opportunities, and he did so with a lot of skill.
Let's move on to the constructors. Ferrari take the lead at the top of the table. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.